Welcome in this class. This is class 6th, subject social science, chapter number 1, civics. The name of the chapter is understanding diversity. So in this chapter we will learn about diversity. This is summary lecture. Basically from this chapter we have already completed lecture number 1 and 2. In this summary lecture we will summarize the topics done there in lecture number 1 and 2. This is basically the recapitulations of the topics done there in this chapter in lecture number 1 and 2. The topics that we have covered in this lecture, in this chapter basically, they are meaning of diversity, diversity in India, different examples of diversity, diversity in writing, geographical and historical factors influence the diversity of a region, unity in diversity, some examples of unity of India. So these topics we have already covered there in lecture number 1 and 2 of this chapter. Now in this lecture we will summarize, we will recapitulate all these topics one by one. So let's start. First of all, meaning of diversity. What does it mean? In Hindi, if we talk about diversity, means vibhinnata. So what does it mean? The sense of variety that exists in the look, religion, language, food, culture, etc. related to the different people. Means different people are having different look, different religions are there, languages spoken by the people, different food are eaten by the people, and the different cultures we are following. So this is diversity. And simple example we can take. If we look around us, we see the different faces, different looks around us. No one is the same. So that shows the diversity in look. So the meaning of diversity, the sense of variety that exists in the look, religion, language, food, culture, etc. related to the different people. If you remember, in this chapter, we had taken one example of a story given there in the chapter. That was a story of two boys in which Sameer Ek or Sameer Do. These two boys are there. Sameer Ek, who is Hindu, Sameer Do, who is Muslim. Sameer Ek is able to speak English. Sameer Do is selling newspaper on the road. That shows the diversity between these two boys. So now let's start with some more examples of diversity and the Indian diversity. So diversity in India, first of all, our country India is a diverse country. Means here different type of languages, different region, religion we can see. So how can we explain the diversity in India? India is called a land of diversities as it is a country having many regions. As we know that our country is divided among 28 states, 9 union territories. So different regions are there. Different religions are present there in India. Basically in India, major 8 religions are there. Different customs people are following. Different food habits are there. Different languages are spoken by the different people. So this shows diversity in India. So how can we explain the diversity in India? We can explain that India is a country having many diversities regarding religion, reasons, custom, food habits, languages, etc. Now we will take some examples that describe Indian diversity. First of all, the first example that is regarding languages. Language there in India, different people in different parts of India, they speak different languages. For example, Hindi, Punjabi, Gujarati, Assamese, Tamil, Malayalam, etc. So different languages are spoken by different people there in India. That shows diversity in language. Next example, religion. Here in India, different religion, the people from different religions are there. Like Hinduism, Islam, Christianity, Judaism or Sikhism, Buddhism, etc. That shows the diversity in religion. Next example, festivals. Here in India, India is known as the land of festivals. So people celebrate different festivals. Holi, Eid, Christmas, Guru Purab, etc. Along with these religious festivals, we are celebrating some festival. Those are national festivals. And in national festival, they are celebrated by all the people, whether they are Muslims or Hindus or Christians. So that shows the diversity in festivals. We take the example of food, like dal chawal, idli dosa, sambar, dal bhati churma. So different type of food items are there in India that are eaten by different people in different parts of India. That shows the diversity in food. We can take a simple example. Even when we meet each other, we greet each other, our friends, our relatives, the word that we use, even that are different. Like we can take example of Punjabis. When they meet each other, they speak Sasai Akal. Even we take example of the people living in northern part of India, basically, they speak Namaste. So different words we are speaking when we meet each other, the word for greeting. So that again shows the diversity in India. So we can take different more examples for explaining the diversity of India. So I think it is understood with the example, the diversity in India. Now, diversity in writing. Basically, diversity in writing that prove us that whenever we have everything same, one color is there around you and we have only one vegetable, one fruit, what will happen? There will not be any interest. So in writing, and in writing also the writers will write the same, and it will not add anything, any interest in our life. So what is there? The writers or the authors, they have the diversity, diverse ideas, diverse imaginations with them. Some wants to write about childhood memories. Some want to write about accounts of king, those have interest in history. Some want to write about life of poet, some about fights and friendship, some about value and education. So on, different topics we can take. So this shows diversity in writing, and that really add interest in our life. So that diversity in writing, that add interest in our life. Otherwise, if everything is same, it will be boring for us and we will not be learning anything else. We will be having the same ideas. So this shows the diversity in writing, that different type of the ideas and imaginations the writers are having, and they are writing those thoughts they are in their and their imaginations in their writings. This is the diversity in writing. Now, the next topic, geographical and historical factors that definitely influence a particular reason. Here in your chapter, the example of two places are taken. One is Ladakh and second is Kerala. If we take example of Ladakh, first of all, geographical factors, or you can say geographical location of Ladakh, how it influenced the people living there in Ladakh. As Ladakh is located at high altitude, so the weather is cold there. And as weather is cold, so definitely people wear woolen clothes. And if woolen clothes they are wearing, so definitely what will happen? The demand of wool. So what type of work people do there? They rear sheep. Why? Because we get wool from sheep. And from those sheep they get wool, then they make woolen cloth. And they sell that there in the market to traders. And the very famous wool, Pashmina wool, that is really very famous and costly even. By selling that wool, they earn their livelihood. Even in Kashmir, in India, Pashmina wool, that is really very famous. And very good wool it is. Now, the next thing, the people there in Ladakh, what type of things they eat? They eat meat and milk products. So if we talk about the geographical factors or geographical location of Ladakh, according to that, the people, they wear woolen clothes, the work they do, they rear sheep, The things they eat, they eat meat and milk product. That is just according to the geographical location of Ladakh. If we talk about the historical factors, there in Ladakh, Buddhism that reached there, Islam also it was introduced there, and due to that, population of Ladakh is influenced by both the religions. How Buddhism reached Tibet via Ladakh. Ladakh is also called Little Tibet. Islam was introduced in this region more than 400 years ago. Means Islam was introduced there more than 400 years ago. And there is a significant Muslim population present in Ladakh. Ladakh has a very rich oral tradition of songs and poems. The local versions of Tibetan national epic, the Kesar Saga, are performed and sung by both Muslims and Buddhists. Here, the national epic of Tibetan that is known as Kesar Saga, that is performed by both the religious people, whether they are Muslims or they are Buddhists. So this also affect the population living there, that influence the people living there in Ladakh. That also add something to their diversity. So definitely, the geographical and historical factors of any of the place that influence the people living there. The next example is of Kerala. As Kerala is there in South India, and so it is coastal area. So and what type of work people do there? They grow spices and rice. Along with this farming, they do fishing also, as it is coastal area. The people in Kerala wear cotton clothes. That is according to the geographical location, according to the weather they are in Kerala, and they eat fish and rice. If we compare Kerala and Ladakh, so we can compare that people there in Ladakh, they wear woolen clothes. Here in Kerala, they wear cotton clothes. Their people, what type of work they do? They rear sheep. Here in Ladakh, they grow spices and rice. Means they do farming and fishing. They are the people, they used to eat meat and milk product. Here, the people, they eat fish and rice. So that difference is just because of geographical location. Now, if we talk about the historical factors, here in Kerala, the Arab travelers came here. And in those Arab travels, the famous one was Ibn Battuta. Ibn Battuta was one of the Arab traveler, and he wrote different travelogues. Basically, travelogues means the explanation of the journeys. Whatever journeys he made in his life, he wrote there in travelogues. The second one, Portuguese people came here by sea route. And the first Portuguese who came here in India was Vasco da Gama. So, because of all these historical influences, people in Kerala practice different religion. There in Kerala, people practice different religions like Islam, Christianity, Hinduism, Buddhism. So that again, we are talking about that historical factors also influence the people living there in a particular reason. So here we talked about the geographical and historical factors of any of a place that influence the people living at their particular place. Now, the next one is unity in diversity. As we talked about diversity till now, we have done the meaning of diversity in India, different examples to prove the diversity in India. After then, our country is a unite country. As all Indians, we are one. So how can we describe this unity of India? Despite all the diversities, as Indians, we are one. We celebrate national days with equal zeal. We sing national anthem with same passion. This shows unity. Whenever national anthem is sung there any part of India, so whether any person who belong to Muslim community or Hindu community, they all respect it. So this shows that the people have the same passion there regarding the national anthem. So this shows the unity of India. And do you know, national anthem is composed by Rabindranath Tagore. Now we will take some examples of unity in India. I think unity is clear to you. As we have done diversities, even these diversities in India, as Indians, we all are one. We celebrate all the national days, whether it is 15th of August, whether it is 26th of January. So we celebrate all these national days with equal zeal and we sing national anthem with same passion. That definitely shows a unity. The next thing, the different examples of unity in India. First and very important, independence movement in India. If we go back in our history, we can see there that at the time of independence movement, all the people from all communities, all religions, they came together to fight with Britishers. So that shows our unity. The best example it is that during the time of independence movement, all the people from all the religions, they came together. Even if you remember in previous lecture, we have done one example that was the example of Jallianwala Bagh massacre. That had happened there on 13th April 1919 when General Dyer ordered for open firing on the innocent people, those who were gathered there at Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar. And due to that, many innocent people were killed there. And the people, those who were gathered there, they were from different communities, different religions. That was also one of the example of Indian unity. Now, the second thing, the book, The Discovery of India, that is written by Jawaharlal Nehru. He described about Indian unity in his book. According to Jawaharlal Nehru, in his book, he says that Indian unity is not just outer appearance. It has the deeper meaning. According to him, here in India, different faiths, different beliefs, different religions, they are equal. And we even encourage them. We even encourage others' religion, others' custom, belief. So our unity has the deeper meaning. By saying only that India is a united country, it is not just outer appearance. It has the deeper meaning. We really respect each other's religion. So according to Jawaharlal Nehru, in his book, The Discovery of India, he described about the unity of India. So here we talked about in this chapter, the different topics like diversity, meaning of diversity, different examples of diversity, diversity in India. Then we have done after even diversities, India is a united country. Then we have done different examples of unity even. So this was all there in this chapter. I think you have understood this chapter now. Now let's discuss the homework. Do the given assignment. This assignment will be uploaded on EdQuark homework site also. So listen the questions. Those are given there in the assignment. And this is the combined assignment of chapter number 1 history and chapter number 1 civics, because later on after the discussing of assignment there will be the test of both the chapters together. So the question number 1 is, answer the following questions. Do you think the term unity in diversity is an appropriate term to describe India? Here in this question, basically, you will explain Indian diversity first and then unity. How after the different diversities, India is a united country. The question number 2, who composed our national anthem? Question number 3, give one way in which Kerala and Ladakh are different. We have done many ways. So any of one you will explain there in this question. Now, the fourth question, where are Suleiman and Kirthar Hills located? The question we have done, they are in history chapter number 1. Why do you think ordinary men and women did not generally keep records of what they do? What is Ladakh known as? And the seventh question, give example of unity in diversity among Indians. Here one example you will give. So these all questions you will attempt. They are in assignment. The next question, tick the correct answer. The kingdom of Magda was located on the banks of Indus near the Ganga Valley in the Garo Hills region. Next is, where the Pashmina shawls woven? The different option, Kolkata, Kerala, Kashmir. The next one, which of these is not a reason for diversity? Means, these three parts are given. Among these three, which is not a reason for diversity? History of a reason, traveling from one part of the world to another, living at a place for a long time. Fourth question, which of the following products is found in Ladakh? Among these all three, you have to put tick there, which is the product found there in Ladakh. The third question, fill in the blanks correctly. A British journal opened fire on a public meeting in Dash on April 13, 1919. Means here you have to write the place. When people travel to other places, Dash of Cultures takes place. Number three, the name India was given by the Iranians and the Dash. Number four, inscriptions were written on hard surfaces like Dash. So these fill in the blanks you will attempt. Next question is, match the following. Here you will match the correct match these things correctly. Narmada Valley, Magda, Garo Hills, Indus and its tributaries, Ganga Valley, and in front of this B is column B. The first cities developed, hunting and gathering was done. Cities about 2500 years ago developed there. Early agriculture started. The first big kingdom. So you will match them. So again, I am reminding you that this assignment is of chapter number 1 of history and chapter number 1 of civics both, because the test will be conducted these chapters together. Now, let's start with the homework solution of lecture 2. As in lecture 2 of civics, chapter number 1, some questions were assigned to you. Question number 1 was, write the line in the poem, means the poem that we had done in lecture. From there, you will write the line that was sung after Jallianwala Bagh massacre, which according to you reflects India's essential unity. You have to write the line which shows India's unity. So the line that reflects India's essential unity is, the blood of Hindus and Muslims flows together today. Here they are talking about different religions. They were together, gathered there at Jallianwala Bagh. Second was, who is the writer of the book The Discovery of India? Jawaharlal Nehru is the writer of the book The Discovery of India. Next question it was, list three ways in which the different geographical location of Kerala and Ladakh influence the following. How the geographical location of these two places influence the food people eat, the clothes they wear, the work they do. So, first number, the food people eat. Ladakhi people eat meat and milk products. And people in Kerala eat rice and fish. Second number, the clothes they wear. Ladakhi people wear woolen clothes and people in Kerala wear cotton clothes. That depends on geographical location. As they are in Ladakh, it is cold weather, and there, according to the weather in Kerala, people wear cotton clothes. The third one, the work they do. Ladakhi people rear sheep for its wool. They sell it to the traders, and people in Kerala do fishing and farming. They grow rice and spices. So these are the different that geographical location, according to the geographical location of both the places, Kerala as well as Ladakh, that we have done in the chapter. I think you have understood the chapter. Thank you. Have a nice day.